Ladies and gentlemen, we are back. Last time, Christian overcame the odds. He won the Rumble as entry number 15. Wow, it was quite wild, but we're back in the title picture. We got a chance to take the title from the man that stole it from us. Right there, Chris Benoit. And by the way, that IC title, boys, never lost it. The game stole it from me as well. No respect for Christian. That's what I'm starting to see as the theme of this season, Moa. Also got my Triple H water this time, so thank God for that. Crossface sign, get that out of here. Eject that guy.
Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, it is my great honor to present the winner of the Royal Rumble.
Just close your eyes. Yeah, dude, the crowd's cheering me. What's going on here?
He defeated 29 other superstars to earn an opportunity at the World Heavyweight Championship.
As the winner of the Royal Rumble match, you are entitled to a World Heavyweight title match in 3 weeks' time.
Let's go. No! This man, he's everywhere. Why? Oh my god, here we go. Left his title backstage, I guess.
Let me get this straight. This is the challenger for my title? What is this? Some kind of joke?
Excuse me? What?
Listen to me. I hope you're not getting your hopes up. Because I'm going to WrestleMania as the champ, and there is nothing you can do about it.
Wow, dude.
The champion certainly seems ready. For his sake, I hope the challenger is as well.
I failed to remember the part where you pinned me at the Survivor Series, Benoit. You think just because you have a good theme as well, you can talk smack about me? You jumped me backstage that one episode, too. Insanity. Oh, God. Kane, why?
Listen, I know that you and I haven't always seen eye to eye. But I just...
Eye to messed up eye.
In my opinion, you're going to go down in the books as one of the greatest champions ever.
that delivery and that voice line. By the way, have you even had any interaction with Kane? I don't remember interacting with him that much at all.
The champ's full of crap and everyone knows it. Fortunately, he's not going to be the champ much longer.
Oh my god, the menacing dialogue.
I can't wait to see you take him down in a few weeks.
The respect. Christian accepts. Look at Kane's face, dude. Oh my god. Yeah, so this is interesting because we played this storyline on the SmackDown side, but the February pay-per-view is No Way Out. So there is no... we're on Raw, so we can't go to No Way Out. So I believe our title match is just going to be on a regular Raw, which is actually quite interesting. Oh, here we go. Triple H. I still believe this man was part of the screw job. He was in on it. Just like always. In on another Survivor Series screw job. He kept me at bay. And Shawn made sure not to interrupt the sharpshooter. And we don't know if John Cena actually tapped in that match or not, because he was blocked by the barricade, so did the bell get rang? I don't know. Hey, Triple H, I got water too. Look at that's actually WWE brand water. Look at it. But Triple H doesn't realize I'm actually waterproof because my theme song is sung by Waterproof Blonde, so his water tactics have no effect on me. Triple H shrine. It's so good, dude. Heroes for our time. So actually, I don't know. Am I a face or a heel still? Because they cheered me when I introduced for the Rumble, but I don't know if they just always do that, because I didn't do anything specific that would make me a face, I don't think, but... Christian! I'm getting my title back for all my peeps out there. All the ones who still believe in me. And if I don't, I'm altering history and I'm going to TNA early. And there's nothing Vince McMahon can do about it. And I'm not putting that blue dot over my face. I'm not going to let that happen. I talked to the guys in the production truck. We're not doing it. And that guy always has a CLB sign, always disrespecting me. Wow. I'm still honestly shocked I won that Rumble. I thought it was over for sure. Got knocked down to 15. So I think I dropped about 5 spots if I was at 20, but I don't remember what I was at before that match. I'm Jim Ross with Jerry the King Law. Yo, what's up, Triple H? You try to bury me, huh? Screw me over at the Survivor Series? I know you were in on it. I was wearing a wire backstage. I heard it all. Let's see if I can get this. Actually, I should have just mashed X to show off what happens if you try to mash and cheat that. Damn, if that comes up again, I'll do it. If I remember, which is going to be tough. Maybe in one of the alternate stories that will come up. I mean, we still got some more matches, so it's possible to come up. Alright, two dirty boys going at it. See, that's another thing why the AI is dumber than I remember. Like, why would they try to take off the turnbuckle pad when you're not stunned or down? Like, right in front of your face. Like, it's kind of frustrating to be honest. Look at it. I mean, I guess I was stunned that time, but still. Big clothesline from Christian. Actually, I want to find that romp and stomp and headlock. What is the input? Oh, here it is! Romp and stomp and headlock! Come here, ring the bell! Ring the bell, Earl! Give this man a taste of his own medicine. Combos, you can combo out of that too, that's sick. God, speaking of Triple H water, I really need to grab some water right now. My throat kind of hurts from talking so much. These long recording sessions take their toll, man. Okay, I didn't realize to turn around, okay. Should I try to actually win with that romp and stomp and headlock? Come on! This is personal. This is absolutely I'm doing it again. This is personal. You were part of the reason I lost my title. Jeez, I need to grab some water. Where's a long submission move I can do? There we go. See, Triple H, I drank the water. I didn't spit it out. I don't waste like you. Come on. Yep. Targeting the liver. There's a lot of pride on the line. Liver boys. And nobody wants to go back to the locker room as the loser. Dude, honestly, I wish they would counter more. Like, even on Legend. Come on. I mean, there we go. But, I mean, I say that now, but when I get to 06 and it becomes a reversal fest, it's going to be interesting to see if I get tired of it after a while or I enjoy the challenge. I don't know. You know what? This is personal. This is personal. This is personal, guys. Come here. Nowhere to hide. There's nowhere to hide. This is right in front of the CLB sign guy. I didn't do anything. I don't know what you're talking about. Nothing happened. I was just in the ring taunting the whole time. Oh! He uses backstage powers to hold Christian down. I think this is all a conspiracy. Vince McMahon, I think, turned his back on me and I just didn't know. And he conspired with Sean and Hunter here to hold Christian down. They don't want him in the main event scene. They only gave Benoit the title to keep the suspicion off. It was a master plan, guys. Triple H is going to take back the title at WrestleMania 20. History is going to be altered unless Christian does something about it and grabs the title. Combos into taunt. Let's go. You know what? You pedigreed me to cost me the title? Come here! Pedigree! Peepagree! Oh my god, we got some orange cheese in the house tonight. I'm surprised that's not a rope break, that's pretty close. Wow! I just disrespected this man, but he deserves it after what he did to me at the Survivor Series. It was all a plan. The Survivor Series match, I got screwed by Triple H, Shawn Michaels. Why is this still in the game? Yukes, please! At least the camera angle is not as bad as Here Comes the Pain, but Yuke's, come on now. Now that I'm thinking about it, is that the last game? Or is this the last game that that animation appears in? I really hope so. I'm pretty sure it is. Oh my god.
Help! I need some medical help over here!
Help!
What the? There's a man down!
Wow. Kane's dunzo.
Looks like someone took him out, JR. I wonder if this has anything to do with what he said earlier tonight.
Yep, Vince McMahon's cronies took him out. Conspiracy by SmackDown and Kurt Angle? I think not. I think Vince McMahon's pulling the strings and utilizing SmackDown superstars as well as, you know, Triple H, Shawn Michaels. It's an overarching conspiracy to ruin Christian's career. What's up, best friend Kane? Hey, how you doing, Kane?
I've been better, but I'm feeling a lot better than I was at the end of last week's show.
Do you know who jumped you? Is it Shane O'Mac?
Yeah, it was your pal, the World Heavyweight Champion.
Let's get one thing straight here. He's not my pal. He's not my friend. I want him removed from this season mode.
The GM put me in a match with him tonight, and I'd appreciate it if you'd be the special referee. I don't want him pulling any more dirty tricks. I couldn't ask for anyone better to watch my back.
Dude, Kane's voice acting. I'd be happy to do it, Kane. You're on, Kane. Very well, Kane. I'll do it, Kane.
The champion will be in a match tonight, and the special referee will be the number one contender.
That seems like a conflict of interest to me, JR. I hope Eric Bischoff has thought this one through.
Yeah, so you can see exact same storyline except for on Raw that we had as Eddie Guerrero. So I could skip this, I guess. But let's just play it. Special referees are always fun. They're more so fun when you're playing with real players, in my opinion, at least. It's Christian. I don't get a ref shirt. I'm not cool enough. Question is, am I going to call this down the middle? Or do I just beat up Chris Benoit the whole time and send him a message? Once again, that CLB sign guy, ridiculous. I can't take him anymore. Get him out of here. This whole season mode determines Christian's path forward. If he fails, doesn't get the title, he's going to TNA early, confirmed. It will be removed from all copies of SVR06. We will enter an alternate dimension. This becomes the truth. I'm playing a magical copy of this game that affects the past. This is my best friend, Kane. I'm gonna burn down the arena. Dude, if only there was a cutscene of him like setting JR on fire, that'd be pretty funny. Or like a storyline where he sets someone on fire or something, you know? That's something I'm probably going to talk about in the credits. Obviously, like, it would be great to have more storylines, but you also got to take into account this game is put on a DVD, so limited disc space, and also time constraints. It'd be interesting to see them, like, do a season mode similar to this nowadays with the increased, you know, storage capacity of, like, Blu-ray discs. Record a ton of storylines. It'd be awesome, man. This is a disgrace right here. Complete disgrace. Hey, remember, you beat a SmackDown superstar to get that. You defeated a SmackDown superstar to get the world title. Ridiculous, man. And Ric Flair is teaching us how to be a ref. Thank you, Ric Flair. All right, see what we got here. Come on, let's see you prove you're the world champ. And you know what? I'm actually going to call this down the middle. Which is something I typically never do in my playthroughs, but why not? I'm not going to do anything here. Prove to me you at least deserve to be in the conversation as world champion, sir. Come on. See what you got. By the way, I don't know if I mentioned this, but it still is really interesting. They gave his secondary finisher as a sharpshooter, which, yeah, I know Benoit did a sharpshooter, obviously, but they gave the flying headbutt as the default move, which is interesting to me. You would think the sharpshooter would be the default move and the headbutt would be the alt finisher, but not. The Kane's destroying him. Come on, he's supposed to be the world champ, my man. Defeated a SmackDown superstar for it. I wish that we would have got Elimination Chamber instead of Hell in a Cell, honestly. Like, I knew something like that would happen, like... Well, I didn't know exactly, but I figured something like that could possibly happen, like, because I was talking about how I was, like, fearing that storyline. Gotta get some Triple H water here. He's actually got Kane yellow, wow. Because, man, those Hell in a Cells are so risky, especially when you can pin anywhere. Like, you gotta have eyes everywhere, man. And if you fall off the cell even a couple of times, you have mega damage. It's wild. It's kind of fun, though, playing those. But there's too much red in this match. I'm the only blue boy here. Get out of the way. Come on, get him out of the corner, Kane. Come on now. I could yellow cheese somebody, fast count him. I said I'm playing this normal, which is something I don't think I've ever done on a video, at least. Come on.
Just the sight of Kane makes my blood run cold.
Rope break, get off him. I don't know what I'm doing, by the way. I'm so bored. I just want to move around.
Rope break.
Yeah, rope break. Get him out of here. SmackDown 1 voice clip. Everyone's going wild with the submissions, man. Dude, enough.
Rope break.
Everyone's trying to send a message here, doing submissions right in front of my face. Honestly, if I get locked in a sharpshooter or crossface, I could probably lose easily. Because think about it like this, right? I don't know, but I'm assuming Benoit either has 9.5 or 10 submission. I don't really remember off the top of my head. But plus you put the, oh, here we go. Plus you put the, Legend, computer that mashes at insane rate. Not a chance I can defeat him in a submission minigame. Unless it's type B. Oh yeah, I forgot, no countouts. You know, it'd be interesting to see if anyone speedruns this game season, because the table strat's gone, so what's the next viable method to speedrun matches, you know? I'd be curious to know that. Dude, this is like a back and forth match. Long taunt, you're locked in, my man. Come on, Kane, my best friend Kane here. Who I swear I'm probably just not remembering correctly, but I don't remember having that many interactions with him at all. Actually, like, none. But also, you know, the parts sometimes have gaps between when they're filmed. Yellow cheese, potentially? This could be yellow cheese, guy. Nope. Alright, he's tapping. I wish there was a screw job option as a referee. I know that got implemented later. But I wish in these older games there was. It'd be so funny, man. Dude, how many turnbuckle pads? That's what I want to know. How many turnbuckle pads have been taken off during these two playthroughs? Too many. Okay, interesting choice for a pin. You call yourself the world champion, sir? Defeated a SmackDown superstar? That's got one question. Why, Sean? Why? That's really my true question from the Survivor Series. Why, Sean? It's kind of funny because Shawn Michaels is the traitor guy in this storyline we got. It's kind of ironic that that went down the way it did. I'm starting to see why I don't play as normal referee now. This is really boring, I'm not going to lie. Because I'm not doing anything. I kind of just want to do it to say I've done it at least once on video. Alright, here we go. Let's see. Let's see how this submission minigame goes. Oh, we can't see it because... Computer. It looks like Benoit's winning. He keeps pulling him away from the ropes, actually. Okay. Wow, Kane's only yellow still. Actually, now I'm kind of curious. If he locks in the crossface on me, is it determined where the bar starts by head damage or arm damage or both? Okay, Benoit is wild. I don't know why Kane's not countering, but he's killing him. He's sending a message to me right now. By the way, Benoit's clean. I disagree. He stole the title. No honor. Yeah, he was just doing his job, but still. God, I really need this Triple H water, man. Now, come on. Someone do something. I might have to intervene. But I already said I was going to be a fair ref. I gotta suck up to the fair ref community, the people that want to see official matches. No nonsense, not allowed to have fun, no screwing around. I gotta please the ref community here. Oh god. Emma losing some clean meter for that, but I doubt this man cares. Kane? Chokeslam. This might be it. He might defeat the world champion clean. Chokeslam. Straight from hell. Oh, I think that was... Oh, come on. Kane, come on now. He's arguing. I don't know. It's hard to determine, like, what if I low counted or, like, slightly too fast. You'd have to, like, watch the referee and, like... Get it down to a science, I suppose. But that felt pretty fair. He just kicked out, my man. Oh, here we go. Dude, I gotta hit the unpretty. Oh! I wish I could see the submission bar, but I guess you can't. Oh. The animation's sick when he grabs the ropes like that, though. That's cool. Oh, I'm sorry. Wow. Okay, I ruined it. I'm no longer an official fair ref. I ruined it. That might have been a rope break, though. I don't know. For all my peeps out there, I'm capturing the title on Raw. And there's nothing Benoit can do about it. Dude, that hip toss animation is great. Kane's about to interrupt the gameplay soon. You know something I just thought of? Imagine if Chris Benoit activated his clean bar. And you remember how it said it temporarily increases your attributes? Do you think that applies to even if you have a max attribute? So what I mean by that is, like, say you have 10 submission and you activate the clean boy ability. Does your submission stat technically go above 10? How would you even test that, though? That's something I want to know. That could be interesting. Because I think in the earlier parts of the Eddie season, I wasn't giving the clean bar enough credit, to be honest. Someone please do something. Fruit roll up, fast count, something. It's so boring. Come on, I agree. Hey, Stappen. Chris Benoit needs Advil or something. Keeps getting a headache. This might be it. Choke slam! Yeah, this is it. Oh my god. That might have been a slow count, I don't know. Alright. Kane has done it. Get him out of here. Supposed to be the world champion, my man? Yeah, get him out of here. Benoit, I swear to God, this season, both seasons have been about you as the overarching enemy. And I honestly wish it was anyone besides you. Oh, no. Christian has died. No! Edge, help! For old time's sake, get out here, Edge. No! I can't believe this. They're in cahoots. Look at my hands. I'm like convulsing.
Oh!
No, and I'm the bad guy. And you people boo me. Wow, Chris Benoit has once again gotten the last laugh. Unbelievable. All right, third week. We're only like 25 minutes in as well. Wow.
You know, a lot of people are wondering why I did what I did last week. Well, the simple fact of the matter is, everything I've said over the past few weeks is true.
Wow. Even the part about the World Heavyweight Champion assaulting you, I don't think that was true.
No offense to the World Heavyweight Champion, but his challenger is eventually going to go down in history as one of the greatest champs of all time.
In TNA.
So if he goes to WrestleMania as the champion and wins, people might start to say that he's an even greater WWE superstar than me. They might start to forget about all I've done, and I'm just not going to let that happen.
They might start to forget about all the people I've set on fire. Look at Benoit, by the way. He's like, what are you talking about, you Muppet?
Don't worry about that. It's not going to happen. He is not going to win at WrestleMania.
See? The problem with him is that he believes his own hype.
Wow.
He thinks he's the greatest wrestler to ever set foot in a WWE ring. You know, this guy's ego is totally out of control, and he doesn't realize that all the boys in the back and all of these fans want to see him lose that title and get the beating of his life.
Again, I think I brought this up in the Eddie season. What title? Where do you talk? The crowd's booing. Are the peeps on my side again? There we go, it's Christian! First off, Benoit, what title are you talking about, my man? Did you get a concussion last match, or what happened? So that's what you guys think, huh? Well, I've got an idea, Kane. If you want to give me the beating of my life, why don't you step with me in that ring tonight, my man, and try to do it without hitting me from behind this time, you big red coward.
You're on.
The challenge has been accepted.
Wow. Just close your eyes.
There's a lot of bad blood here tonight, JR, and I wouldn't be surprised if we saw it flowing by the end of the night.
Kind of makes me want to bust open Kane now, to be honest. I need my revenge. Look at this coward, man. With Chris Benoit, excuse me. I don't have any divas to back me up anymore. They're all hanging out with Eddie. Look at this. Kane won the collect the Chris Benoit storyline. Wow. Wow. Cutscene entrances, boys. Here we go. Triple H bottle of water. Alright, fans, I know you're cheering me during the cutscenes, but I'm probably still dirty. So I don't really know what to think anymore, to be honest. But check out this magic trick. I'm over here. Now I'm over here. Can you believe it? Just close your eyes and enjoy the magic of Christian. You can't hold me down, Triple H, HBK, Kurt Angle, Vince McMahon, whoever is holding me down. The powers that be backstage. They just don't see Christian as a big player. I'm gonna change their mind. I'm changing everyone's mind. Matt Hardy, the man I believe I eliminated last in the Rumble. Alright, here we go. Let's go. Whoa! Everyone's dirty besides Benoit. I don't care. This crowd's wrong. Benoit's the heel in all this. Always has been. Oh god, I can't pick him up, that's right. Now, this will be interesting, I suppose. Oh yeah. Now I don't remember if I had trouble with the manager when I did this match as Eddie. Oh no. With them distracting the referee constantly. I really don't remember even who I faced as Eddie, to be honest. Come on. Strikefest 2020. Get your tickets today.
Okay.
Okay. I don't have memorized all my non-lifting moves. I didn't plan for this. Plan C has failed. Aye.
Kane is 7 feet and 320 pounds. A pure psychopath.
Yes, sir. Nightmare strats. I think I might have talked about this in some other videos or streams, but I'm personally not a big weight detection fan. I know it's realistic, obviously, but I'm not a fan more so of the way it's presented in some of these older games where basically those moves I have where I lift them up are just useless. They don't do anything. I liked whatever game started where they would substitute them out for non-lifting moves. So if you couldn't lift them up, you did a non-lifting move instead. I thought that was fair. I just think the way it's presented in these old games, it's like literally like a bunch of my moves, as you can see here, are completely useless, you know? Like, I just don't see how it's fair. I think they went a little overboard with them, to be honest. But I can also see why some people like them, you know?
And now he's taunting his
opponent. I think, honestly, it's worse than the Rumble. Oh, excuse me. Why? I just tried the same exact move. Christian! Or what about in like Day of Reckoning where you would like mash to like that meter to lift him or not? That was a pretty cool idea, I think. I mean, I don't know. Come here. Don't make me lock in the romp and stomp and headlock. I need to defeat one person with that headlock, to be honest. No! Wow. Dude, Kane's gone crazy here. I don't want to get stepped on or set on fire. Right, come on, I'm Captain Charisma. What's ironic is even though I have max charisma, I'm actually not gaining that much momentum. It might have something to do with the fact that my strength is hard capped at 7. I can't go any higher. So I might not be outputting enough damage, but I don't know. I didn't really compare to when I had low charisma. Wow, Kane's actually giving me a challenge here. He's actually reversing a lot. I like this. Where was this fire before, huh? Oh, God. Exposed turnbuckle coming into play. Okay. No way. Yellow cheese, please.
This is one for the books, Kane.
Wow, what he keeps doing is the strikes that override grapples. Christian Rumble strats. Nope, okay. That punch helped so much during the Rumble. This one, right? Okay. I've been hit with the running clothesline like 40 times this match. But, 41 times this match. So this punch I was talking about. Because I was talking about in that last part, how like I thought a quick jab, you could infinitely do it if you time it perfectly in the Rumble. But it seemed like I was also able to do it with that move. It was just really hard to time, so I didn't really get it every time. Come on! Whatever it takes. I don't know how these fans can cheer Chris Benoit. I'm the good guy. I don't care what they say. They're wrong. Except for all my peeps up there in section 204. Wow, dude, where was this difficulty earlier? Like, this is actually a good match. Back and forth. But now it's time. I forgot what the romp and stomp and headlock input was already. Even though I just did it like, I think like one match ago. Oh! Right into the steps. Expose this man. Using the environment. High IQ. Future Edge taught me that. Use your environment to your advantage. Ultimate opportunist. 42 times, by the way, that clothesline.
He's showing a great deal of confidence by taking the time to talk.
Where's the romp and stomp and headlock? Yeah! Stomp away on the mat! It's so loud! Oh. Where's a mod that makes that ring mat stomping audio 50 times louder? I could edit it in the video if I wanted to. But I don't want to blow out people's eardrums. Here we go. Romp and stomp and headlock! Christian stomping away. I need to get somebody this so bad. I might actually try to get Kane, to be honest, but I need to get his head red. Oh my. Wow. He sidestepped and then striked. Threw me off. Wow, Kane's wild, guys. Alright, do I got a non-lifting move? Yes. Christian combos. Come here. Boo, that's right. Boo some more. Think I care. I lost everything. Because a SmackDown superstar submitted. Not even me. You know how it feels? That stuff taken away from you? You did nothing wrong, guy! Christian's dead. Computer's stupid. It seems like they don't drag away from the ropes like they do in Here Comes the Pain. And my question is, why? Like... Oh. He wanted to make sure I was dead. Really? I just got murdered by Kane. I was about to go on a rant about how they don't drag away from the ropes, but... I got chokeslammed and stomped a few times and that was it. I just lost clean. The world champion loses clean to Kane, clean Keen, and then I lose clean to Kane, but Kane doesn't get a title shot. Wow. Yeah, it just wasn't enough. My peeps out there, I failed.
What do you expect, King? It's supposed to be a mano a mano, but it's practically a handicap match.
Yeah, JR, I agree. Even though Benoit didn't interfere, guys, the odds were against me. Wow. Dude, Kane was actually a challenge that match, though, which... I lost 4 SP for that. Wow. Kane was actually reversing a lot and like playing smart. That was... Where was this fire from the other AIs? So I was about to talk about how I feel like the AI is better and Here Comes the Pain, honestly. Like, I feel like they reverse a little bit more. You know, the fact they actually interrupt pins, it seems better. Okay, this is also another pivotal moment of the season mode. If I fail, it's over. Look at Big Show! Look at Big Show with that huge WWE title.
I know you're all wondering why I'm here, so I'll get right to the point. WrestleMania is 1 month away, and so I'm proposing we make it the biggest WrestleMania ever.
Like in that alternate universe where Eddie Guerrero was in this.
I'm proposing that in the main event, for the first time ever at WrestleMania, a unification match for the WWE and World Heavyweight titles. Both brands' champions compete in one match to prove which brand is the dominant brand in sports entertainment.
SmackDown versus Raw.
So what do you say, Eric Bischoff? Have you got the guts to put your title on the line?
Nickelodeon guts. He's calling out Eazy-E. How will he respond? Big smile on the Tron.
Have I got the guts? Look at my career up to this point. Look at my history of uncompromising success, and that history will continue to be written beginning at WrestleMania. Of course I accept.
Wow.
The World Heavyweight Championship and the WWE title will be unified at WrestleMania, King.
You know what's interesting? If I actually go on to face Big Show, I won't be able to lift him.
I can't believe it, JR. Just when I thought tonight's event couldn't be any bigger, this happens. It's incredible.
And it all relies on this match. If I fail, Christian's done in the world title picture. Oh, no. Triple H
hey,
water.
I'm sorry to interrupt, but I've been meaning to say hi to you for a while. It's just kind of tricky to do when you're not on the same show.
Excuse me, ma'am. You are on Raw?
but I watch Raw every week, and I've got to say, you're incredible. I asked Kurt Angle to bring me along tonight, just so I could meet you.
Want to betray Jericho at WrestleMania?
I really like what I've seen of your show so far. I'd love to be on it, you know, so I can get to know you better.
Oh my god, look at Big Show, oh my god!
Trish, there you are. Come on, it's time to go. What are you doing wasting your time this jerk anyway?
Come on, it's time to go. Now listen, Big Show, you need to stay out of this nonsense. I'm not watching your show in the future, you know?
Come on, Trish, we're leaving. See you around, chump.
Damn. Chump Stain Challenge failed.
Did you see that, JR? We almost got a sneak preview of WrestleMania right there.
Pretty ironic, because regardless if you win or lose, that does foreshadow WrestleMania, because either you're involved in Trish storyline or the title picture storyline. That's really interesting looking back on that. Okay, it's all down to this. Can I do it? One more match. That's all I ask for, Eric. One more match. If Christian fails, he fails here in his final chance. His main event picture is over. He's got to go prove elsewhere he's a big star. We'll see, though. Once again, that guy with the sign. Get him out of here. I'm honestly really scared about submissions. He's got two submission finishes. Legend difficulty submissions are really like... The only chance I have to get about getting out of those is rope break or a big counter right away. Look at Kane! Oh... Had to have Kane with you, huh? Kane looks so awkward. They're moving in slow motion back there. Wow, this is it, guys. After all the backstabbing. After pinning the wrong guy at Survivor Series. After restarting the Rumble. It's all come down to this. Face to face. Man to man, I wish the manager wasn't here, but this is it. Here we go. I ain't messing around. You also got to take into account, Benoit probably has near max technique, I would assume. Again, I don't have stats memorized, but you would think he has max or near max technique. Come here. I got to use the dirty bar to my advantage. I think that's Christian's key to victory here. Come on. I ain't messing around, Benoit. Fast strikes. Christian combos, you ready? No. He was ready, actually, yeah. Hip! Dude, I'm opening up strong. Oh, he's gonna grab me. Hip! Choke him out. It's the shoot. I want my title back! I want my title back! Dude, I ain't messing around. He's got no momentum. I got everything to prove against this man. Again, sometimes the AI does running grapples when you're on the apron, which doesn't even work. I don't know why they do that. They even do that in the Rumble. Oh, no. Okay, I see you. You're not walking out here with the title. I won't let it happen. I didn't come this far to fail, Benoit. I got something on my screen. Get off. No! Okay, good. Imagine if my screen went out and then I couldn't see and tapped out or something. That'd be wild. You know what? Romping, stomping headlock. Come on. Come on. No! Oh, no! Oh, wow. That just barely escaped there. Dude, I feel like I've done 10 times more moves than him. But look, he has like just about... Like, not more than me, but a decent amount of momentum. Oh. Yeah, you can see submission type B, Chris Benoit's got high stats, so his thing moves slower and the bars were pretty a lot bigger. Dude, we're at Reversal Fest, guys. Sequences. You know what? Time to play. I need to be playing like a heel more. Fans want to treat me like this? I'll give them a reason to boo. Come here.
Oh, I respect Christian's ability.
Oh, God.
I just can't stand the creepy little, you know what.
Come here. This is my low blow. Big neck break. I'm targeting the head this match. I might try to make him tap to the romp and stomp and headlock. But that's really risking going for a specific finish. I'm also concerned Kane's going to distract the ref, so I might try to take him out before hitting my finish. Yep, targeting that head. Well, he got up immediately. Earl, I want you to keep an eye on Kane. I will set that man on fire if he tries anything crazy. Give me that dirty bar. Yep. Christian, top tier dirty guy. He's up there. He's got the move set for it. Come here. Oh, okay. Scouted. I had a man scouted, my man. This is the true ending of the season, Mo. I don't care what happens after this, because this is the overarching story. Oh, God. I cannot let him get any type of submissions like this, man. Those are going to wear me down big time. Like those arm bars he does and stuff. Like, I don't want him to like lock in 10,000 of those that he did Kane. No, come here. Foes him. No! Sacrifice some clean bar, but I doubt he cares. Wow. He keeps recovering so fast from that DDT. And running grapple on the apron because SVRAI, ladies and gentlemen, come here. Come on, Benoit. Come here. That's right. Boo.
That should be a disqualification right there.
No DQ, JR. Read the season mode rules, JR. You know what time it is? Rump and stomp and headlock. This is risking. This is risking. Look how big his reverse bars are compared to everyone else. I mean, he still hurts, so they're pretty low, but still. Okay. Remember, yellow cheese is also a factor. So regardless of how good oh no. Okay. There we go. Gotta get away from Kane. Got some power grapples, but some strikes first. No. Oh wait, no. Wait, dude, if I get pinned off a submission with yellow cheese, that's ultimate disrespect right there. Choke him out! Alright, keep booing. Keep booing. Oh, why am I doing this? I'm gonna lose dirty bar if I get three of these in a row. I guess I should intentionally miss the third one, right? Terrible. Oh my god. Big monkey flip. Yeah, I'm not risky. I'm waiting until his head's red, which it is now. All right, here we go. Unpretty. Let's see if he actually distracts the ref. I don't know. He didn't. Wow, it's over. Wow, I thought he would. Okay. I thought it was going to be a struggle because the computer would actually give me a challenge with the manager thing, but they didn't. Why? Christian is back on top. Despite the powers that be backstage. Kane has left the building to set someone on fire. Close your eyes.
He's on his way to WrestleMania, JR, where he's going to face the WWE Champion in a unification match. I can't wait to see what's going to happen between now and then.
Just close your eyes, everybody. Get him out of here. Look at this. Get him out.
But this year won't be any different.
The feud is officially over. Get him out of my season mode. Where's my title? Big Show, you're next. I can't lift you, but I'm ready. Wow. I want everyone in the audience, just close your eyes. We're back. Christian's back. Captain Charisma is back where he belongs. There you go, 99 superstar points. The interesting thing here is Kane beat Benoit and myself, and he doesn't get a title shot, so get him out of here. All right. Anyways, that will do it. So this will be the final part of the next one will be the final part of the basically the SVR dry run this season. Then after that, we're going to be covering alternate stories and then, like, you know, standard bonus stuff I usually do. So I'll see you next time for the conclusion, plus the credits as well.